10 years old, full of tap metal filings, at least two shoes worth. And it's all falling apart now. And bless its heart, the handle, this cheap little thing stayed on, taped on.
I had these two rather large, maybe it's about 2.5 feet by 4 feet dance boards. This one happens to be only 1/2 inch ply, so it tends to be a little bit on the trebly side, as opposed to when you get 3/4 inch ply, that is going to be more on the bass side. So you get a deep, richer tone the thicker the wood, but it's also heavier. Since my other dance board is so very disgusting after 10 years, I would make a new one, so.
I went to Home Depot where I bought the boards many years ago, and the man was nice enough to slice them into 2 portable dance boards for me, one square and the other rectangular. Then I went over to the local Ace Hardware where I got a door handle and asked the gentleman there to screw it in for me.
Just trying to get it relatively centered.
Wasn't that fun, Mr. B, running over to Home Depot and then to the Ace Hardware store in your neighborhood where they gave you a dog treat? Yeah.
Now, theoretically, this could be a problem if your surface was very smooth and flat, because your handle would be touching the floor and potentially, you know, it's not going to be flat. However, I am going to tape an exercise mat to the bottom of this, so that won't be an issue with the bottom. But maybe my tap might hit the top. But I made the mat in the old one a little bit bigger than the edge of the board to increase stability, because it creates more of a steady surface. This mat is also thinner than the previous mat, which actually may be better because it might be more stable. Okay, so what I did here is I trimmed the piece of exercise mat then, but I'm gonna go ahead and use a preliminary tape to kind of set where I want the line up to be. Some painter's tape. So here you can see I've cut the exercise mat to match the edges, and I transplanted this little extra piece. Now the question is whether I've cut it to the, you want to make sure there's no space on, you want to make sure it's flat. See whether this falls flat on it before I give it the good duct tape, final seal. Hope this lasts another 10 years here. Let's see, which side should I start on? I'm not as handy as you all out there. Got so many DIY subscribers. So yeah, you know what? This is interfering with my grip space. I'm actually cut this edge down before I tape it. Might do this end first, however. So you notice I start on the mat side and I go up to the board. That's to make the mat kind of curl up. So that's the top. I can't let the tape go too much on the board because that's gonna mess up. I can't dance on that. This is no dance zone, so. Is my sort of finished product. I basically took pains to try to seal all, especially the corners, all the edges, because when you put this on damp grass, water seeps in and
makes the edges grow. So try to create a seal and not let the tape cover too much of your dance floor up. Now, unfortunately, I think I left too much mat on the bottom. On this surface, I feel a little bit of movement in the board. It may stretch out. It may have to do with the, you know, because as you're taping it, you pull on it, try to get it flat. You might pull a little more than one place than the other. Anyway, we'll have to tap on and try it out.
So let's test out this board. Well, it actually, even walking around the edges, now it's actually more stable than before. I think the mat may have stretched out. Initially, there might have been a little bit of pocking. You can immediately tell that's a trebly sound. It's very high-pitched because it's only half inch. At least the mat underneath absorbs some of the excess, you know, it's very tapping sound, but the 3/4 inch board was a more richer sound. And in any case, this is lighter to carry. In a large jam, you kind of, outdoors in a large jam, you kind of like that trebly pitch because it sound carries better. I just personally don't like it, especially for indoors, because it's very rat-a-tat-tatty. You can try to, you know, you calm your steps down so you don't give so much power. That's some of that metallic sound. You really can't hide it. It's very metallic. But so from the one big board, we have this one nice portable one. We have a longer one, which I'll probably just put a handle on, make sure that the handle grip doesn't protrude. The other one I may not put a mat on. So I think mission accomplished. I think this one is definitely a lot less disgusting than the old board.